Florence Villeneuve.
Hey, Jeannie.
Hi, Flo. France is the number one tourist destination in the world. People love France. There's one thing about France they don't like so much. That is the French tendency to complain. Of course, France is known as the pinnacle of that one formalized process of complaining, striking.
Absolutely. And complaining is linked to another cliche that we have explored about the French, and that is their reputation for being world-class champions of pessimism. But complaining is such a massive stereotype about the French that it really does deserve its own show. Are the French really world-class complainers? Well, they're the first to admit that the reputation is somewhat deserved. In fact, we like to joke here that the national sport isn't football or tennis or cycling. It's complaining.
C'est vrai que les Français sont râleurs. On manque de positivité. Ça, je pense sincèrement.
Est-ce que ça vous arrive de faire la gueule?
Ouais.
Pourquoi?
Bah, lever du mauvais pied, un tour de merde, la grève, ça arrive, ouais.
Now, you might have heard of that expression, faire la gueule. That's actually just one of many expressions about complaining in France.
There's an arsenal of vocabulary around complaining, and that's quite telling. Let's take a look at a couple of examples, starting with faire la gueule, which means to, you know, be moody or to be sulky. You've also got se plaindre, which is the word you use for regular old complaining. Porter plainte is more official. It's a way of complaining that will have consequences. Grogner is something that actually is to growl, kind of like a dog. And then protester, surprise, surprise, is to protest.
But perhaps the word that best describes complaining here in France is râler.
Râler, which is our word du jour. Râler means to essentially grumble about things, and it's summed up quite well by a word, or a sound rather, which is a sound that you hear quite a lot coming out of the mouth of French people. Now, râler actually comes from a breathing noise. Le râle is the raspy noise that a dying person
The death rattle, in fact.
And in France, râler is so important that it's actually somewhat of an art form. Take a listen.
On est extrêmement râleur. C'est un cercle infernal. En fait, t'es obligé toute la journée, tu râles. Tu rates ton métro, tu râles. Tu t'attends 5 minutes ton café, tu râles. Ouais, c'est un mode de vie, en fait.
That was comedian Olivier Giraud, who has an acclaimed show that's called How to Become Parisian in an Hour, because the truth of the matter is that on a national level, the Parisians are the national champions when it comes to complaining. Just listen to people from the rival southern town of Marseille.
Nous, on a la mer, le soleil, le mistral, voilà. Les oreillers.
Il n'y a pas le soleil, la mer, voilà, je crois que c'est tout. Ça fait tout. Comparé à Paris, la pluie, le mauvais temps, les râleurs.
C'est pas un secret, hein, le Parisien est grognon à travers les bouchons.
Les Parisiennes n'aiment pas les souris.
Okay, so Parisians complain a lot. I think it's safe to say the French complain a lot. The big question is, what are they complaining about?
Well, there was a study that was carried out a few years ago, and the results are pretty fascinating. The number one thing that French people tend to complain about is problems with bureaucracy and administration, you know, the post office, banks, insurance, red tape, essentially. Number two, transport delays and strikes. Number three, the government. Now, what's interesting is that personal issues come down really low on the list that French people choose to râler about. It tends to be about external issues. And that brings us to a very important point that can actually get lost in translation, is that it's not really that French people are in a bad mood all the time. It's that complaining actually has kind of a social function here. It's a cultural, conversational tick, the way that Americans will ask, how are you doing, without really caring about the answer. And more than that, it's actually a French way of doing small talk, perhaps the way the English talk about the weather, because it's an easy way of bonding over something that's not personal.
Okay, I get that complaining can sort of be a conversation starter, if you like, but it is a cultural quirk that can be really uncomfortable for foreigners. For example, if you take Anglo-Saxon countries, complaining is seen as negative, it's confrontational, it's jarring, it's just not nice.
Absolutely, whereas here in France, it kind of comes part of kind of our way of critical thinking, our love of debate, our desire not to be too starry-eyed and optimistic about things. And some even go further and say that complaining is actually good for you because, and I must admit, grumbling can actually be quite therapeutic and cathartic at times. Just getting it out of your system is actually a lot better than keeping it bottled up. And after all, French people have the reputation, and scientifically it's been proven, that they live long and relatively happy lives, so maybe it's because of all that complaining. But it's not that simple, because it's not always all that positive. Complaining can also get you caught in somewhat of a spiral. They call it the negativity bias, where essentially you rewire your brain to be pessimistic.
Râler tout le temps, finalement, ça va contaminer tout ce qu'il y a autour, et que ce soit vos collègues, vos amis, votre famille, vous-même, vous êtes complètement intoxiqué par ce côté négatif et pessimiste.
And one last thing that's important to keep in mind is that complaining also has to do with expectations. And French people have quite high expectations about their society, the government, the standard of living that they hope to live. And so complaining, in a way, is part of protecting all that.
So râler, venting a little bit, let's say with moderation.
With moderation.
Flo, thank you so much. Don't forget, if you have other questions for Flo about France or the French, you can always send her a tweet at Flo Villemenot or check her out on social media.